I want to talk about the EndoBoard today, the most underused and wonderful piece of equipment in most gyms. It's underused because we watch the freestyle athletes jump on it and do 360s, cool tricks, and you look at it, you think, that's wonderful, but I'll never do that. The truth of the matter is you can use an EndoBoard functionally for all your body parts. So today we're going to go through a couple of chest exercises, back exercises, shoulder exercises, ab exercises, and leg exercises. Basically, an EndoBoard workout. I want you to get comfortable using this just as an everyday piece of equipment so that instability becomes a regular thing with you. We're going to get started. Chest exercise number one is the EndoBoard push-up. Push-up with a plus. Get over your EndoBoard. Take your feet a little wider than you normally would for push-up. Chest right over top of the board. Bring yourself with perfect posture down to the board. Exhale, push yourself straight up. The EndoBoard push-up, chest exercise extraordinaire. Full range of motion. Proper posture, head in line with your spine. Chest over your hands. Get yourself right over top of those hands. Full range of motion. Bring yourself right down to the bottom. Exhale as you push yourself to the top. Perfect posture. Exhale. Stand up. EndoBoard push-ups. Great chest exercise. EndoBoard chest exercise number two. Press with a plus. Another plus. Find yourself on your board. Grab your dumbbells. Load yourself up. Get your balance, lift your hips up high, push, exhale, push. Keep a plank position, your abs are tight, your hips are high. Bring those dumbbells right down to the front of your shoulders, exhale as you push up. Don't let your head drop out of line with your spine. EndoBoard press with dumbbells. Chest exercise, number two. Last one. Bring it down, drop your hips. Boom. EndoBoard back exercise, we're going to a Superman. So we want to lie down prone on your stomach, actually on your chest on the EndoBoard. Looks like this. The idea is to keep yourself flat. Find that spot on the EndoBoard. Glutes are tight, upper back, shoulders. Exhale as you lift. Small movement, great exercise. Don't lift your head up. Your head stays in line with your spine. You want beautiful posture as you go through as full a range of motion as you can. This is the EndoBoard Superman, and it is Superman. Sometimes you don't even need to use the whole EndoBoard to get the benefit of EndoBoard. EndoTube. We're just using the tube for a one-arm row. Beautiful posture. Feet a little wider than hip-width apart. Line yourself up over top of that hand, shoulder over your hand, and you're just gonna row and release. Hips stay square to the floor. Shoulders stay square to the floor. Tuck that elbow in close to your body. Exhale as you pull. Hold your posture tight. Release. The EndoBoard dumbbell row is about stability over that tube. It's a very freaky feeling. Shoulders on my EndoBoard. We're gonna do the alternating dumbbell press on the Endo. Address your EndoBoard. Bring your dumbbells up. One arm at a time. So you're actually playing a little balance and a little weight as you shift from side to side. Full range of motion, dumbbell to your shoulder cap to a fully extended arm. Your feet are gonna play underneath you just to find that perfect spot. The beauty of the EndoBoard with an alternating press is the play. The way the weight shifts from foot to foot as you go individual shoulders. But it's a great shoulder strength balance exercise. More EndoBoard shoulders. We're gonna do a dumbbell rotation. We're gonna keep our posture correct. I'm old, I don't want to be hunched over. Address your endo board right up top. Got a perfect, two perfect angles, one at my armpit, one at my elbow, 90 and 90. I'm gonna come no lower than my shoulders and rotate right back. So it's a dumbbell rotation, And it's all about posture, standing straight, eliminating that part of aging where you start hunching your upper back. We're gonna stand tall, chest up, exhale as you rotate and open right up. Upper back and shoulders pull tight. The endo board, not just for balance, it's actually for core stability, for ab work. Got two of my favorite ab exercises on the endo. First one, basic crunch. I'm gonna sit on the end of my endo. Find that balance spot so the endo is flat and just reach up. I'm gonna bring my rib cage and pelvis, I'm bringing my rib cage and pelvis close together. Exhale as I lift up. Again, head is in line with my spine as my abs tighten. Lift, small range of motion, but a beautiful range of motion. Up and down. I'm shortening my abs with each contraction, extending my abs. Not losing my lumbar curve, little curve in the small of my back, but maintaining it. Not bigger, not smaller. Abs longer, abs shorter. If we have more abs on your endo, it's a tuck, it's a crunch. You address the endo board on the floor. You're gonna take your knees to the top end of the endo, toes to the back end, level that board off, tuck your pelvis in, draw in close, and release. Exhale as you draw in close, and out. The idea is keep that board flat through this full range of motion, flat at the front, flat at the back. Draw it in close and extend. Keep your abs tight. Don't lose that back. Pull it in close. Weight shifts to my toe. As they extend, they have more knees on the board. I come to toes on the board, trying to keep that board flat through an extension and a flexion all the way in. So I want to show you that the endo board is not just for the cool kids in your gym. Don't be afraid of it. The learning curve is really fast. You're going to get your balance soon, but you have to do it in a safe fashion. I use a chair, or I'd get behind a bench, And I'm going to put the board down. I'm going to step one foot on the low side of the endo board. I'm going to grab the chair, take my foot on the high side. With both hands on the chair, I'm gonna find my balance in the middle. I'm gonna come right down to a full range motion. I'm holding on to something. So my balance is not compromised. I'm gonna stand up tall and I'm gonna come down low. I'm gonna practice my full range of motion without letting go. You gotta find your confidence on the board before you move on to anything else. You come down to a full range of motion. Bring yourself right up. Don't let go. You want to hang on and come right up. Don't let go. When you're learning, hang on. Keep a hold of something through that full exercise until you're confident and comfortable. The most basic of all endo board exercises is the squat. I put my foot on the low side, the high side. Find the center. If I want to use my arms for balance, they're out. If not, doesn't matter. But I want you to sit down with a perfect full range motion. Don't lose that back posture. Push your hips back, keep the weight on your heels, and come right up. Endo board squats. The board's always gonna move a little bit. No one's perfect. So don't worry or try to overcorrect. Just find your spot over the board. Keep your chest up, look ahead. Come on up. Again, recognize, you're not gonna lose it down here. If it goes a little bit one way or the other, your body's gonna find it. Just relax and come up.